अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी विल कवर अ न्यू टॉपिक विच इज़ कुटेनियस एंड मोटर इनर्वेशन ऑफ लोअर लिम्ब। कुटेनियस मीन्स स्किन एंड मोटर इज रिलेटेड विद मसल्स। सो वी विल सी दैट व्हाट इज द नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द स्किन एंड द मसल्स ऑफ द लोअर लिम्ब। Cutaneous nerves are present in the superficial fascia or the subcutaneous tissue, and they supply the skin of the lower limb. These nerves arise from T12 or L1 spinal nerve, and they are the branches of lumbar and sacral plexus. The areas of skin supplied by individual spinal nerve, including those contributing to the plexus, are called as dermatome. You should know what is dermatome. So, area of the skin which is supplied by an individual spinal nerve is called as dermatome. See here they have shown dermatomes in the lower limb. Okay, they have colored different dermatomes with different colors. Okay, see here the nerve supply of the anterior view of the lower limb and the posterior view of the lower limb. See here, this is lateral cutaneous branch of the subcostal nerve, which is supplying the upper and the lateral region of the lower limb. Okay, the upper part of the thigh, which is lateral part, it is T12 area or T12 dermatome. Okay, then see in the middle of the upper part of the thigh, this part is supplied by the genitofemoral nerve. Then there is ilioinguinal nerve, which is supplying the medial part of the uppermost part of the thigh. Then we will come towards the middle region of the thigh. Here there are three nerves which are supplying the middle part of the thigh. What are those three nerves? Number one, the lateral part is supplied by the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh. Then the middle part is supplied by the anterior cutaneous branch of the femoral nerve. Then the medial part is supplied by the cutaneous branch of the obturator nerve. Then we will come towards the leg. See here, the knee region, it is supplied by the saphenous nerve, which is the branch of the femoral nerve. Okay, there are infrapatellar branch of the saphenous nerve also. Then we will come down, and in the leg we can see the areas which are supplied by the saphenous nerve and the area which is supplied by the common fibular nerve or common peroneal nerve. The fibular and peroneal are same. In some books it is written common fibular nerve, and in some books it is written common peroneal nerve. So this is the area which I am showing you with the cursor, okay, or I can show you with the laser pointer also. See here, this is the area which is light blue in color. This area, it is supplied by the lateral sural cutaneous nerve, that is, which is the branch of the common peroneal nerve. Okay, then we will come down. See here, the common peroneal nerve will give two branches. What are those two branches? Superficial peroneal and deep peroneal. Superficial peroneal is also called as superficial fibular, and deep peroneal is also called as deep fibular. Okay, so this area, which is the lateral part of the lower part of the leg and the anterior surface of the foot, okay, except one region, which is in between the big toe and the second finger, okay, this is deep, supplied by deep fibular nerve or the deep peroneal nerve. Okay, this is the cleft in between the big toe and the finger. Otherwise, the anterior aspect of the foot and the upper part of the foot, that is the lateral region of the lower part of the leg, it is supplied by superficial peroneal nerve. Okay, see here, superficial peroneal nerve. When we will see the posterior view of the lower limb, we can see some nerves here. Okay, can you see nerves? Superficial or superior clunial, then medial clunial, and there are inferior clunial nerves. The word clunial, it is related with buttocks. So buttocks are supplied by superior region by the superior clunial, medial region by the medial clunial, and inferior region by the inferior clunial nerve. Along with these clunial nerves, there are two other nerves which are supplying the region of the buttocks. What are those two nerves? Lateral cutaneous branch of the iliohypogastric nerve and the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, which is supplying the lateral part of the buttock. When we will come down in the thigh region, we can see here The lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, which is supplying the lateral region, and the cutaneous branches of the obturator nerve, which are supplying the medial region. Okay, and the posterior part is supplied by the posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh. Then we will come down in the leg region. You can see here, this is the medial part. It is supplied by the anterior cutaneous branch of the femoral nerve, the upper part, and the lower part is supplied by the saphenous nerve, which is the branch of the femoral nerve, and the lateral region, it is supplied by the common peroneal nerve or the common fibular nerve. Okay, and then we have the medial sural cutaneous nerve from the tibial nerve. See here, this tibial nerve, it is present in the posterior compartment of the leg. Okay, then we will come down in the foot region. We can see here there are two plantar nerves. One is medial plantar, because plantar region is the lower region or the sole of the foot, is also called as plantar part. So there is medial plantar nerve and the lateral plantar nerve, which are supplying the medial and the lateral part of the sole respectively. These medial plantar nerves will supply medial part, lateral will supply lateral part. Then we have the medial calcaneal branch of the tibial nerve. This is over the calcaneum. Okay, so it is supplying the calcaneum, that's why it is called as medial calcaneal branch. It is also the branch of the tibial nerve. So these are the cutaneous nerves which are supplying the skin of the lower limb. Okay, you can see here the dermatomes of the lower limb, okay, or the segmental pattern of the distribution of the sensory nerve fibers. Okay, they are present here. They have shown the dermatomes only, T10, then there will be T11, T12, then this is the region which is supplied by L1, then there is L2, then when we will come toward the leg, around the knee, it will be L3, then the leg region is supplied by L4 and L5, and the lateral part of the foot is supplied by S1. Then see here the posterior view. You can see here the clunial part or the buttocks region, it is supplied by S3, S4 and S5, and this is the lateral region, which is supplied by L2. Then we will come down toward the popliteal fossa. This is supplied by S2. Then we have L4 on the medial region of the leg and L5 on the lateral region of the leg. Okay, and there is L5, which is also supplying the inferior aspect of the sole of the foot near the big toe and the second finger and the middle finger. Okay, this is L5. Then we have over the calcaneum and the lateral two fingers, they are supplied by S1. Okay, so you can see here the dermatomes. Okay, in this chart they have written the names of the nerves, okay, which I have described you earlier, their origin, that from where they are coming. For example, the subcostal nerve, it is coming from T12. Then the iliohypogastric nerve, it is coming from the lumbar plexus. Ilioinguinal nerve, it is also coming from the lumbar plexus. And the genitofemoral nerve, it is also coming out from the lumbar plexus, from L1 and L2. Then the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh. Then there is anterior cutaneous branch. Then there is the cutaneous branch of the obturator nerve. Then the posterior cutaneous nerve of the thigh. Then there is saphenous nerve, which is coming out from the femoral nerve, having the root value L3 and L4. So these are the origins of these contributing spinal nerves. And here there is written the course, that from where they are coming, okay, or from where they are passing. And this is the distribution in the lower limb, which you can read and learn, because this chart can come in your MCQs as well as the short essay questions. Okay, so please learn this chart by heart. Okay, see here, in this they have given the superficial fibular nerve, which is also called as superficial peroneal, coming out from the common peroneal. Then the deep peroneal, coming out from the common peroneal nerve. Then there is sural nerve, which is also coming out from tibial as well as the common peroneal nerve. Then there are medial and the lateral plantar nerves, which are coming out from the tibial nerve. Then there is the calcaneal nerve, which is coming out from tibial and sural nerves. Then there are three clunial, which I have told you earlier, the superior clunial, the medial clunial and the inferior clunial nerves, which are supplying the skin over the superior, medial and inferior parts of the buttocks respectively. So these are the nerves where they have given the name then the root value or the branch from which it is coming from, then this is the cords and this is the distribution that it is supplying which area. For example, I will tell you that deep peroneal or deep fibular nerve, which is the branch of common peroneal, it is supplying the skin of the web between the great and the second toe. See here, I have told you earlier also that it is supplying the skin of the web between the great toe and the second toe. Okay, I will show you in the diagram also. See here, this is deep peroneal nerve. So all these pictures and charts are very, very important. Learn them by heart. Thank you very much.